Hello and welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My name is McKenna and today I want to have a conversation about something. So this is a topic I have found kind of interesting recently. In the past year or so, been getting a lot more into like more eco-friendly options for things. I want to be more sustainable and I want to be more eco-friendly, and I was curious how books kind of fit into this. So I did a little bit of research on the sustainability and eco-friendliness of print books and ebooks as well, and I have some notes and some thoughts, and I don't want this to come off as preachy at all. I'm still gonna continue to buy books, I'm still gonna continue to buy ebooks. This is just what I found. I hope no one takes this as a like, how dare you still buy books, because I'm still going to. It's not like I'm stopping buying books and you have to too, and here's why. I just wanted to do this research to be more conscious in myself, and I've kind of been buying less and less books more recently in my life, and kind of only really getting books that I know I'm interested in, or I do sometimes buy on a whim, like I think we all do. But I just kind of wanted to talk about all that and put it into a full video for Earth Day. I also want to say, I think most of these articles that I bring up don't have like BookTube in mind specifically, because I think BookTube as a whole are a lot more like willing to, or more apt to like donate, sell anything books after they're used, as after they've been read and like after an unhaul, as opposed to like someone just throwing it away or something. So I think that's also something to kind of note and keep in mind when talking about this. But without further ado, let's kind of just get into it, because I'm interested. So when I started the research for this, my general consensus was probably that ebooks are most likely more eco-friendly or more sustainable than print books, and that's not necessarily the case. Depending on what you read ebooks on, it is worse for the environment to manufacture an ebook than it is, or like an e-reader, than it is a physical book. So I think this is from the Custom Made blog, E-readers versus print books, and it says 1 year of use offsets an e-reader's lifetime carbon footprint, provided the e-reader is substituted for more than 22 books. And then another study found that a person would need to read between 40 and 50 books in order to equal the fossil fuel use, water use, and mineral consumption of one e-reader. But if climate change and human health consequences are factored in, that number can grow to more than 100 books. I think the other thing not factored in as far as like BookTube and like the book internet sphere is like buying an ebook and a physical copy. And that's not a bad thing. I don't think it's a bad thing at all, especially for like book collectors, but that's also not factored into the overall thing. So I don't know. It's like I said in the beginning, I'm not shaming anyone for anyone's life choices. I still buy books. I'm still gonna buy books. I'm still gonna buy ebooks. I just wanted to be more conscious of the decisions that I was making in the book buying stratosphere. Another tip that was in that article was to buy books online as opposed to in like a physical bookstore, because it takes a lot of pollution of like driving the books to that bookseller, and then you driving to that bookseller and you picking up a book and then driving back to wherever it is, and then when not all the books are sold, they have to come get picked up again. And I'm not 100% sure about that one, but that was also something that was mentioned that I thought it was worth noting. I think a lot of people, especially in the past year, have been buying books online a lot more than in person, so I don't think that's a huge issue, but this article was written before the pandemic, so there's that as well. In an article published by greenmatters.com, around the mid-2000s, the publishing industry took a hard look at the environment and the environmental impact it was creating. Book publishing has been designated the third largest industrial greenhouse emitter when it comes to pulp and paper. This one is from LifeGate, Sustainable Book Reading. According to the New York Times, the materials used to produce an e-reader equals at least 50 printed books. While the Book Industry Environmental Council, BIEC, is more optimistic as it claims that the increasing use of e-readers will reduce greenhouse gas emissions by 20% by 2020 and 80% by 2050. I don't know where to check those facts and see if they've been reduced by 20% as of 2020.
I just looked it up and they actually reached that 20% benchmark by 2012 because it was a 2008 forecast. It was either 2006 or 2008 forecast, and they reached it by 2012, that 20% emission cut, so it happened.
Also in that article, according to a study carried out in 2009, ebooks have a greater impact than printed books, but when a considerable amount of paper books is collected, the impact of the latter balances the former. In conclusion, what is the more sustainable way of reading? And that is the big question. I have more things here, but I think it's really just a personal decision. I think if you're reading off of something like an iPhone or an iPad that you're using for other things, and you buy the ebook instead of buying the physical book, or buy the ebook before you buy the physical book, that could end up being the more eco-friendly option. Or it could not. I think it all really depends on different things happening. Different situations. It all depends on the specific situation that you are in buying this book, whether ebook or physical book, or even audiobook, which is like also ebook, but you know what I mean. In an article published by TCK Publishing, the sad truth is that around 10 million of the trees that are killed each year to create books die in vain each year because the books end up getting destroyed instead of read. However, shipping books is expensive, so instead of sending books back, bookstores often rip off covers and only send those back to the publisher as proof that the book has been taken out of circulation. In other cases, they rip off the cover and send the now unsellable book back. Either way, the book can now never be sold because it is so severely damaged. Those damaged books are then pulped, ground up, mixed with certain chemicals, and recycled into paper for other uses. That's right, every year we're destroying more than 16,000 truckloads of books, enough to fill both the British Library and the Library of Congress twice. They were never even read once. So that's like all resources-wise I had, but personally, like I said, I'm gonna continue to buy books. I don't think I'm really gonna stop buying books ever, but I have personally, like before even talking eco-friendly, I have just kind of started dialing back on the books I buy and try and keep it minimalized to books that I know I will like or books that I have already read and do really like. Otherwise, I just try and listen to the audiobook or get it through the library, which is another great resource. I know that some people also haven't been able to use the library, haven't felt comfortable using the library because of the pandemic. I am luckily in a situation where I feel comfortable and can use my public library pretty frequently, despite the pandemic, and I do frequently use the library. It is one of my greatest resources in finding books that I am interested in, even some that I'm not interested in, and I also use their like online resources for ebooks and audiobooks, which I think is another great resource. As long as you have, if you're like on your phone or on your iPad or computer, something that you're kind of already using, that's going to offset that kind of emission that's not used, or that rather than using something that is strictly for reading, you are using it for something else. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing that you have a strictly e-reader, but that's the kind of consensus of all of the articles that I talked about. I guess that's really all I have on that one. I can't really think of anything else particularly to say, so let me know down in the comments below what you think of this. Your opinions on this topic, I'd be interested to see. And as always, make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you sometime for a new one. Bye!